Hi everybody, it's Saturday and I'm vlogging. I have a cameraman today, which is weird, but okay. It's been a long time. I haven't vlogged a very long time. So I'm just gonna update you. This may be long, but bear with me. Okay, so this week I have been working a lot. I've been working here and there. That's nice. I've been floating around, so to speak. So floater life is good. It agrees with me and it makes me happy. I feel like I'm learning a lot and I'm valuable and essential and things, but it also scares me because I feel like at any minute this call end and then I'll go a long time without work. But I've been blessed enough lately that I have work, so I'm gonna keep working. So I can get into a lot of things, but I'm just gonna break it down for you right quick. Okay, so the extent of this week has been me working at the store downtown, and it's been nice, with the exception of this new pharmacist that we have. She's replacing this Chinese pharmacist that we have that I love, and she's going away and I can't see her anymore, and it's sad, but maybe sometimes she'll float and be in our pharmacy. But in the meantime, I have to deal with her. She, I had to work with her yesterday. It was not good at all. She was not making the work day better. I'm having a hard time sleeping, like a lot. So, I was dreading going to work. I can't tell you how exhausted I am every morning. But I have to work, you know. I feel bad calling out now. It's not like before when I used to go to work and I had the luxury to call out and things like that. And now I feel like I can't, you know, like every second counts. So I have to make every second count. So as bad as I feel a lot of the mornings, as much as I don't want to go to work, as sick as I feel, as sore as I feel, I have to just go to work. And so that's what I've been doing. So yesterday I get to go to work with this new pharmacist. She is younger than me, and she has just graduated college and she's now officially a pharmacist. So I'm working with her, and I've told you lately in the floater life I'm a little more talkative, a little more social. Yesterday with her wasn't like that. It was really awkward and it was very quiet for the most day, and we got to work. I'm used to a busy store because the last store, my home store that I worked at, was so busy. I mean, you had no time to do anything. The only time I got to sit down was in the bathroom. I didn't even get breaks, you know, so. Working with her today, yesterday rather, was busy. But not as busy as a store could be, so it was kind of hard, but I tried my best. I made a lot of mistakes. There were a lot of things that I did that I could have done better. Yesterday, which technically today is Saturday, so yesterday would have been Friday, so Thursday rather, was the first day in a long time that I felt those feelings again, that I felt really inadequate, that I felt like, oh my God, what am I doing here? This is not the job for me. Like, I felt like this other version of myself that was really pathetic and had no reason to bitch and complain. This girl was really backed up. This was like, I think maybe her third official day on the job. And so it was she and I alone for a lot of the day before the other tech came in. So the whole of the day went by with us hardly talking. And when we did talk, it was basically her telling me whatever I did was wrong. God, it was one point where I was typing something. I was told like this. I was trained. But my kid's godmother, my very best friend, she told me this, and she told other people. She's a trainer, so she told us this. When you type out prescriptions, the directions that you have to type out to the customers have to be, like, really in layman's terms, you know? She's like, think of these kids like they're little children. Because sometimes you'll tell them, for instance, if they have a suppository, you have to tell them physically, like, type it down. Insert this into your anus, you know, because if not, there are instances where there are people that will put the suppository where it doesn't go. There was actually a case where, and it was so funny, it was an example she told us. I couldn't believe that an actual person did this. Someone got prescribed a suppository, and they didn't type in to remove the thing from the package and unwrap it and insert it into their anus. So this person actually just put it into their anus with like the plastic wrapping on it, and I think they got sick and things. And so from hence on, we are really, really, like, it's drilled in our mindset to just talk to people like they're kids, you know, like, really, and not even, like, my daughter's really smart, like, you can't talk to them like they're kids, you have to talk to them like they're, like, really stupid kids, and so, just type everything like they're just, like, they're idiots. So, I was typing things, I was giving the customer the benefit of the doubt, that was my bad, America, that was my bad. I was really just typing things like you guys would get it. I was like, take this pill by mouth 3 times a day. Apparently, that was not good enough for this pharmacist. She was like, no, don't type it like that. Type it like this. Type it, take the pill in your mouth 3 times a day. Okay, now, I'm trying my best to give the customer the benefit of the doubt. Like, I don't want to talk to you like you're a stupid ass, and, like, you're an adult, you know? I think you could understand that you have to swallow the pill. I don't think you're going to put the pill in your eye, or you're going to stick it up your ass or in your nose. I'm really, really, really trying to think that you, an adult with better insurance than me, is going to have the common sense to swallow the pill and not put it anywhere else, like, on top of your nose and think that it's going to dissolve and... I'm really trying here. So apparently what I was typing was not good enough for her, and apparently I was typing too slow, so it got to some point where I was typing and she's standing next to me, and she actually physically shoved me out of the way and started typing. And there was another instance where there was like a line of people, and I took another customer on another register, and that register you can only use it as credit, you can't pay cash there, it's just straight up credit card transaction. So, you know, this very sweet woman made the mistake of asking for cash back. She was just distracted. Please, people, if you're in the line, don't text. Like, text later, okay? That confuses you, it confuses me, especially me. So, the poor lady asked for $10 cash back in a register where there was no cash back, and so obviously I had to call the manager and like all these things. And God, this new pharmacist just, oh my God, she went like fucking ape shit on that. She just went crazy. She's like, no, don't use that register ever again. And she was in the customer's face. I was more embarrassed for the customer than I was for myself, because the customer was like, she broke some kind of cardinal rule. She looked at me like, oh my God, I'm so sorry. And I had to keep reassuring her over and over that things were going to be okay. But, God, this new pharmacist just... God, she just did not know, like, manners. She did not know how to react at all. She didn't know how to interact with people. I'm not sure if she's been around many people lately, but whatever. So, I kept giving her the benefit of the doubt. I kept praying for her and praying for myself. Like, God, please just get me through the day. I don't want to... Oh God, I don't want to kill anybody. I don't want to... God, I've left a trail of bodies behind. I wanted to start fresh this time. Like, come on, God, please. So, I was really hoping this time would be different, that there wouldn't be a body count behind me. Like, this time it's going to be different, you know? No more slangs unnecessarily. So I kept praying for the woman and praying for myself. And... But I did. I gave her the benefit of the doubt. I kept thinking that, maybe she was having a bad day, maybe her period was on, maybe a boyfriend broke up with her, maybe her car didn't have gas, maybe, you know, I don't know. I just kept giving her the benefit of the doubt. So then, later in the day, the other technician that I work with shows up, and she pulls me to the side immediately and just starts whispering, which is never a good idea. You don't ever want to start whispering at work. And actually, it was funny because when the other tech first got there, that pharmacist pulled her aside and was whispering to her. So I'm like, oh my gosh, she's probably talking about me, talking about, oh, this bitch is off the chain, she's an idiot, she's an incompetent, whatever. Whatever, so I expected that. And then later, the other tech pulls me aside and was just bashing this woman and was just like, oh my god, I can't work with her. Please stay. I will take you home. Don't go home. Don't leave me alone with her. In which case, I thought, okay, well, I mean, this is how I feel towards this person, but if someone else feels like this towards them, then I think maybe this person isn't having a bad day after all. Like, maybe this person just is that in general. Maybe she's just a bitch. And so, whatever, I got through the day, and I got to go home, and it was okay. Today I go to work, which is Friday, but I'm vlogging, it's a little bit earlier, so it's Saturday. Or later, rather. And I really am dreading going to work. I'm actually, today's the first time and I can't tell you how many years that I cried before going to work. The last time I cried before going to work, I was a manager at a KFC. And I hated my job so much. I would cry every morning before going to work. I was like, wow, I hate my job. So I was really dreading going to work. I thought that I had to work with this woman again, and you can't imagine. But I get to work exhausted because I don't sleep the next day, the following night, rather. And, God, instead, I get to work with the pregnant pharmacist, which I love. I love her. She's so sweet. And she's basically asking me how was the day before, how was the other pharmacist, how was things. So I told her how it was. She wanted to hear about the experience with the other tech, which got there at 4 when I was leaving, so I was going to stick around so we both could kind of share what was happening. Like, it's just not me complaining about someone. I don't want to get her in trouble and things, but like, I want to let the other pharmacists know that this girl, like, made my day harder than what it was, you know? So, today I was surprised because my day went by, like, really good. It was such a good day at work. And then what made my day more was that the pregnant pharmacist told me today that she had permanent work for me. I'm not going to be a floater anymore. No more floating. She wants me to be at her store. She wants me to work every day, no weekends, from 8 to noon, which is about like 3 or 4 hours or something. I forget. I'm not good at math. 4 hours, the camera person is telling me. And 4 hours every day. And that's about 20-something a week or whatever. My cameraman is calculating. My cameraman is my boyfriend, by the way. He's the human calculator for me. 25? 21? 22? 20? Babe, I don't know what that is. 20? 27?
20.
20 hours. Okay, 20 hours a week, which is good. It's good still. But the thing that I love the most is that she told me this is permanent. Like, look, I have a permanent spot for you. It's going to be about 15 to 20 hours a week. 8 to 12, what do you think? No weekends. What do you think? I'm like, yes, yes, yes. Then the pharmacist later, she's such a sweetheart. She even told me, she's like, listen, oh my God, I'm so sorry. I didn't even ask you if this is what you wanted. I just assumed. To which I responded, I felt like I wanted to kiss this woman. I was like, yes. Don't assume all you want, you know, that's fine. So, I was pretty happy. But yes, I have permanent work every day, which is great. And my car, my check this week is good, so I'm going to fix my car. I'm going to pay my rent. I'm going to have a little bit of money left over. And so, yes, I have a car now. So, that's good. I'm going to be able to go to work, take my kids to school, pick her up from school. I'm going to be able to just float around still, so to speak. If I can, I have the car, so I can do that. Maybe like a Monday or whenever they need me. So, but things are looking up for me. I also, on my bad day, which was Thursday that I got to work that evil pharmacist, I found a $75 gift card on the floor for Macy's, which is just like a boutique or whatever. I got to check out the gift card today. It was empty, but whatever. I found it, so it brought me happiness when I needed it. Although it was very fleeting, but whatever. It made the day not seem so bad. But I wasn't exactly too hopeful that the $75 were gonna be there. But whatever, it doesn't matter. I feel more comfortable like that. I think I would have felt more bad going to the store and spending $75 on just, I don't know what, because I haven't even been to that store. God, I haven't been to that store since I had a credit card from that store. And I think I had to be, like, in my 20s, so that says a lot. And back then, oh my God, I bought bullshit, so I wasn't exactly looking forward to spending. I didn't even know what I would buy. I would probably bought just, like, three things, and it would have been $75, so. This is better. I think it's better. That card was not for me. I was not. It was a nice thing to find, but that wasn't my card. That was actually somebody's card for their birthday, so at least their birthday wasn't wasted. I'm sure whoever found the card or lost the card called, and obviously they canceled it because I checked the balance today. It said zero, so their birthday would still be celebrated. They would probably get another gift card. Whoever lost it probably would have put more money on it, and so it would have been a better birthday for them. So whatever, it's better that way. I would have bought nonsense anyway, so I don't need nonsense. I need my car fixed, and I need to work, and I need what I need. So okay, so on an eating disordered note, oh my God, I feel like shit. It's not good for me. I've been eating all day this week. I lost 5 pounds. I've probably gained it all back, plus 10 more. It's not good. So tomorrow, I'm actually thinking of, I have a lot of my skinny clothes, my skinny jeans, my skinny everything that I'm holding on to. I think it's time to get rid of them. I don't want to. God knows I don't want to. I'm so scared to death to get rid of these clothes. Because if I do, that means that, God, I'm not like a negative zero anymore. I'm like another size. And, oh God, this is so stupid. And now I'm probably like a size 3 or something, or some nonsense like that, which is okay. It's fine. I'm not saying it's not, but for me, it's not. I'm used to being the extreme weight loss size, you know? I'm used to fitting my daughter's clothes. I'm not used to fitting a normal woman's clothes, you know? I'm not used to women's clothing anymore. So this is hard for me, but I think it's that time where I have to just get rid of them already. This is the hardest thing that I would ever have to do. Because I'm just not ready yet. I'm not ready to. I have like 3 pants that fit me, which sucks. Because I have to work every day and I have to dress like office attire. And I don't even, like, I like dressing up and shit, but I don't even feel like it anymore. I went to work today with like leggings and a shirt, and I don't even care anymore what I look like. I'm just so depressed. I don't want to accept that my clothes don't fit me anymore. But apparently I have to give them up. I'm not going to be that skinny anymore. It's so sad. I'm not going to say that. I'd rather nothing. I'm just going to get rid of the clothes and hope that I can be happy. I don't know. That's a lot. So wish me luck that tomorrow I can get rid of clothes and be okay with it and not break down and cry, which I will, by the way. But yeah, so whatever. So anyways, thank you for emails and letters and texts and things. You guys are so sweet. I'm so sorry. I'm just now getting back into writing. I was reading my novel today. I'm gonna hopefully write again soon, and I'll try to write again. So no more videos, okay? So that's it. I'll talk to you guys again next week. And that's it. So good night. Bye.